have to ask, why of all of the franchises you think that Halloween is one that has endured for so many generations and is still so globally beloved?
I think because I saw it when I was an undergrad in 1978, the original. And there were two, I knew in fourth grade I was going to make films, so there were two films when I was in college that really, I came out of the theaters knowing they were game changers. One was Rocky, and the other was Halloween. I walked out knowing that there was something special and unique, and it changed horror. It changed horror films. So because it was the first, and because John Carpenter was so innovative, and because everything about it was so innovative, because Nick Castle is such an incredible creator, I mean, if you look at his filmography, at the films he's done, the bank of talent that were involved in this very unique approach to horror, I think that's what it is, because it was the first of what we now look at it all, Nightmare on Elm Street, Friday the 13th, all these other wonderful films were spawned by the original Halloween. I can tell you my process. When I was called to go down and be put on tape, when the stunt coordinator read the script, he called Malika Cod and David Green, the director, and said, look, guys, you need a guy with really deep acting chops and a really good stuntman. And David Green was, well, yeah, and he's got to be 6'3", 200 pounds, and in his 60s. And David says to Ron, is like, do you know anybody that fits all of that? And Ron said, yeah, I know one guy. So they gave me a call. So when I got the call, I watched the original one time, and instead of thinking about it or making notes, or what I did was I watched Nick and I just embraced his energy, sort of absorbing the spirit that he had created in the shape. And there was a moment when he's walking camera left to camera right in a scene in the backyard, and in my mind I went, I got it. So I pulled his energy in, and then I allowed what Nick created to then drive me. And I had very little direction from David. I mean, I was given point A to point B. I know where my marks were. I know where the camera was. But as far as how I killed people, what I did, all my movement was driven by what Nick had created, and then I allowed to, you know, inculcated. It was inculcated in me, and then that was just a natural reaction or rendering that happened of the melding that happened inside spiritually.
Can you talk a little bit about what that camaraderie was like on set, what your experience was like with the rest of the cast on Halloween?
Oh, man, cast, crew, everything. All of us had a Halloween story. Every one of us has been affected on some level by Halloween. Christopher Nelson, who I spent an hour to an hour and a half every morning in makeup with, you know, he created the mask and all the other beautiful prosthetics. He said to me several times, dude, this is the reason why I make films. This film is the reason why I do what I do. Not only the original did it inspire him, like it inspired me and so many others, the film that we worked on, the version we were working on, it was a family. We were all loving being there. We were all appreciating being there. Nobody was grumpy because we were spending 16-hour days and getting no sleep. It was brutal, and it was cold, and then the summer it was brutal, and it was hot, and I've been blessed to do some really amazing things in my career and have some really amazing times. For me, it was the most joyful and fulfilling experience of my professional career. And I'm still in contact with many of them, people, including Nick Castle, and I are in constant contact. He's just a wonderful friend now. I think it was because we all wanted to be there. It wasn't a job. It was an expression of a passion we all shared. I have noticed that horror fans are the kindest, generous, most generous, sweetest, loving people, I mean, that I have ever met. And as a group, I look at it and go, you know, if the entire world operated like horror fans, we wouldn't need military. And so I think there's a certain catharsis that happens for people who enjoy horror that takes them beyond the need to be violent. They sort of work that out on a subconscious level. So I think there's a sort of a higher vibrational attraction to horror because the people who are attracted to it are so naturally wonderful. And there's a real bond amongst horror fans. I mean, there's a real bond and camaraderie that I have never seen in any other sort of genre appreciation. It's really amazing. Thank you, because without the fans and out their love and appreciation, we wouldn't be here doing what we're doing. And because the fan base is so incredibly, it's so incredibly powerful and passionate. That inspired David Green and Danny McBride and Jeff Radley and everybody who was involved, and you know, Chris Nelson and myself and Ron Hutchinson, the stunt coordinator. I mean, everybody that was involved, we felt the power and the energy behind all that love and that passion, and that fueled us because it's a palpable energy. So I have this incredible gratitude. I feel this incredible gratitude towards the fans, and I experience it in moments like this where I get to do a con and I get to meet each person. And there's so much love. I mean, the love that I get to experience on it's a day filled of drops and drops of love. So every time I get to talk to a fan, on an energetic level, on some macro level, energetically across the planet, there are all these people who have a passion for this franchise and for this film, and they've fed us. And I feel it, man. I'm in touch with it. And, dude, I'm the luckiest guy in the world.